Yeah, I welcome all of you to my channel where we discuss and digest business ideas, investment tips, and forex trading. Yeah, this channel is a very important channel because we talk about advanced knowledge as to how to go about your trading life in the market. So on this channel, we talk about an advanced knowledge as to how to use the updated strategies used by banks and other institutions to trade the financial market. Hopefully, traders, especially those who are struggling, traders and so on, benefit this channel. In this particular video, we're going to talk about part of candlesticks. I also name it anatomy of candlesticks. These candlesticks are very, very important. As you know, we have three types of charts. You have a bar chart, line chart, and a candlestick chart. Candlestick chart, most traders like it because they communicate into detail whatever price is doing on the market to the traders. So we traders, we access more information on the candlesticks. Every part of the candlesticks indicates to this, the candlestick charts. It's very, very, very useful to traders. So this particular lesson is very important because many people don't know how to read candlesticks. Part of candlesticks is different from patterns of candlesticks. After this very important lesson, I'll take you through candlesticks, which is very, very important. It's also called candles. And these candlesticks, as you know, were originally invented by a Japanese man called Kunihisa Homa, who was a rice trader in a town called Sakata. He used these candlesticks to trade before it was introduced to the Western world by Steve Nissen. But there in the United States, they modified it and then forex traders started using it to analyze the market. So that's why up to now, it is still in use. These candlesticks are of two types. You have bullish and bearish candlesticks. Bullish, by default, its color is green on the chart. Bearish, color is what? Red. On your chart, you can customize this. You can use any color at all for it. For bullish candle, it's a candle going upward or bullish, and then the bearish candle, it's a candle that goes downward. That's how it is. So right now we are going at a part of what candlesticks we have. We're going to look at the bullish candle, which is also called bullish candlesticks or bullish candles. They all mean the same thing. Don't be confused. All right, we are done with one aspect. Let's get to the other. That's great. If you haven't made up your mind about whether to trade forex or not, what are you waiting for, my people? Forex is real. It's for banks. That's what banks do, and they are making it big time. Do you want to die poor, my people? Forex will definitely change your life. It's worldwide. Many are trading. They are benefiting. Don't only rely on your salary. Being on salary is one step to greatness. No matter what work you do, you can equally trade forex. Forex is done 24 hours a day. You can start with any capital at all. Minimum $10 are cool to go. You have no excuse to give so far as forex is concerned. Now with the first candle. Alright, so as you can see, this arrow showing upwardness, it means the candlestick is going upward. Yeah, so bullish candlesticks always opens from down and then closes at the top. But before we continue, I think I have to make it more colorful. We are coming to start naming it from the down and then see how it's being done. The whole of this line is called weak or lower weak. And then the very tip here is what lowest price, but we name it low. It can also be called shadow, low range, or lower weak. It can also be called lower range. Have you seen? The last part is the lowest price. Name it low. Yeah. Low means the lowest price. Then the price opens at where the weak meets the body. This very place, this open. As it opens at this level, it has to come down for some liquidity before shooting upward to close at the top. So this place is the main price. As it starts filling its body, this is what they call body. Some people also call it real body. That is where buyers are taking over, pushing the price upward. buyers are in control. As buy orders get increasing, you see that the price pushes upwards to the high. This is the high of the price or the highest level. They all mean the same thing. Yeah, so this sort, the high, the bullish candlestick. After buyers push the price to this level, sellers will again push it downwards. As the sellers push it downwards, it means buy orders are out, becoming less. So it will close at this level. Price will close at this level. You have five parts of every candlestick: low part, open part, body part, close part, and high part. Don't forget, low part is also lowest, the lowest price. Price get to the lowest price. So at the lowest price, buyers clear liquidity. As price starts moving upward, it means buy order in control. Then they will push the price to the highest level, and then sellers will push it downward. Then finally, the price will hold. Stick will close at this level. So that's how it is. The same thing applies to the bearish. All right, then we are done. Yeah. The only difference between bullish and bearish candlesticks is the arrow indicating. As one is going upward, the other one is going downward. But the various parts, let's see the differences that we have as to the path. Yeah. As to how the bearish candlestick opens, it normally opens at the top. It's just opposite of the bullish candlestick. Every bearish candlestick opens at the top here. This is the top. This opens at, after it has opened at this level or this price level, it gets to the high of it to clear some liquidity before heading downward. So what it open price or it open level, it opens at this level. Sellers will push the price upward for some liquidity. So as they put the price upward, that means that's the highest level the price has gone before heading to its original direction. So the purpose of sellers pushing the price upward is for liquidity, for more cash. Before, as the price get to its open level, so you see that more sell orders starts coming in. That is where more sell orders will increase in number. So we will normally call this place the body, or the real body. It is also the heart of the price. That is where profit is. As price gets down below, it will come to this level. This is what its lowest level that it will get to be. So before buyers push it upward, this is our low of the candlestick. Depending on the time frame we are working on, whether 5 minutes time frame, 15-minute time frame, 1 hour or 4 hours. We are working on 1 hour time frame. So the moment 1 hour reaches, then whatever level the buyers push the price to, then it will close. Because candlestick stick opens and closes with regard to the time frame we are working on. So here will be our closing price. Close. And then here's our low. Because this is the lowest level, sellers push the price to. So let's look at the commonalities and then the differences both candlesticks have. The only differences they have is as one closes at the top, the other one closes below. And as one opens below, the other one opens at the top. So in my next video, we will look at various patterns of candlesticks we have. We have so many patterns. So we're going to look at it one after the other. Very interesting. Once you know those patterns, then you can read, you can easily read price action, because those are the basics in forex trading. So everything we do in the forest market has to do with candles. Because candles sells as what? Our prices. This shows price movement. So we are the only things that we see on the market. Apart from candle trees, don't see human beings, we don't see traders. Candle trees represent traders at the same time, prices at the same time, money. So it's very important to know more about it. So never go anywhere, my people. Stay tuned. Always follow me closely. Then I'll give you the best. See you in another video. I love you all. Bye bye.